Hello, hello everybody. Can you hear us?
Yes.
Yes?
Okay. Okay.
So, hello everybody. Thank you for inviting us to ATypy Antwerp.
We would like to present the Missing Scripts project.
So, the Missing Scripts project is coming from these three institutions: Atelier National de Recherche Typographique in the beautiful city of Nancy in France, Institut Design Labor Gutenberg in the city of Mainz, and the Script Encoding Initiative from the Department of Linguistics in Berkeley.
So, the Atelier National de Recherche Typographique is a postmaster of typographic research based at the Nancy National School of Art. It welcomes new postgraduate students every year and brings together experts in the field of type design and typography.
Next slide.
So this is the teacher staff of ANRT, our director Thomas Hugh-Marchand, and the teachers Jérémy Ornus, Roxane Joubert, Jérôme Knobuch, Charles Mazet, Émilie Rigaud, and Alice Savoie. The group develops a singular approach to typographic research with a strong emphasis on connecting theoretical and practical work, as well as on developing long-term collaborations with world-leading research laboratories in other areas, such as linguistics, epigraphy, or computer science.
So perhaps you are familiar with the Decode Unicode project. In 2004, we did the first edition of this poster with a basic multilingual plane of Unicode, every character. In 2007, there was a second edition. Since 2005, we went online. Hello. We went online with the decodeunicode.org website. There was a redesign in 2016. And if you look at the top, there's some kind of slider for, and with these big glyphs. There is one glyph for each Unicode block. And Unicode block is not a script. There could be different Unicode blocks for a script. And this is a custom font designed by Jérôme Knebusch. Then we published in 2011, we published the book with all characters of Unicode 6.0. 109,000 characters. There's a Japanese edition since 2016, and the book is composed of 66 different fonts, because we all know there's no pan-Unicode font yet.
Here you can see how Unicode evolved over the years. In the first two decades, there were updates every 3 to 5 years. Since 2014, the Unicode consortium switched to the rhythm of the smartphone software industry. So now, every year is a new update with more scripts and more emoji. So, as of today, Unicode covers exactly 146 scripts. That is wonderful, a great achievement of the Unicode people. But we asked ourselves, how many are missing?
So we asked Dr. Deborah Anderson from the Script Encoding Initiative from Berkeley. Since 2002, she's working to get more and more scripts encoded in Unicode, to work on the proposal with experts. And as you see on her website, you can read, over 100 scripts remain to be encoded. And she maintains a list with all these different scripts. You can see for some of them, there's already a proposal, but sometimes the proposal is 10 years old and it didn't evolve. For some scripts, there's many missing information. So again, we asked again, how many scripts are out there? And so Dr. Deborah Anderson, she checked all her sources, she asked all her experts around the globe, and she came up with this number, depending how you define a writing system. There are 292 writing systems created by mankind. So if you do the math, there are 146 encoded, so there are 146 missing scripts. So Unicode took 27 years to encode the first half of these writing systems. So you can imagine what's there for the future.
Our next question, what is a script? For these elements here, it is not certain if they are to be considered script. they will need further research. There is no evidence as of today that this element are actually real scripts.
So there was this anecdote that some of these experts said, oh yeah, there is this script, you have to put it on the list, like say Savara. And we said, okay, please send us some samples of this script. And he answered, oh, I don't have any samples. So we said, okay, this is part for further research. If there's not any image of this script, we won't integrate it.
To bring more attention to this raw and obscure script, we came up with this idea. Wouldn't it be nice if we draw a glyph for each of all these writing systems?
So like everybody knows, the letter A, Latin capital letter A, is not just stands for the sound, but it could be some kind of reference glyph for the Latin script. And of course the omega, I would say many people around the globe would recognize it as a representative glyph for the Greek writing system. So the idea how to find the reference glyph for the other 290 scripts. So how to choose the reference glyph? For the alphabets, as you see on the left, there's Osmania, an alphabet. If it is an alphabet, we choose the letter R or Aleph or Aleph. If it's a syllabary, we choose the letter Ka, because in India, many times they use this letter, the letter Ka, for reference glyph for Devanagari. And if it's an ideographic or pictographic script, we looked for some parts of the human body, like this head for Mixtec. there are some scripts not yet deciphered, so what shall we do with this? There's some debate if Rongo Rongo is a script or not. But we decided it's about 10 scripts not yet deciphered. So we decided to put them in. And of course that Phaistos and Linear A is already encoded into Unicode. So we decided to put the not yet deciphered in. We've seen this character several times at this A-Type-I. Today and yesterday, this beautiful film from the Japanese colleague, the character for eternity, perpetual, permanent, and so on, like the reference glyph for Chinese. But you could ask yourself, is the eternity, could it be longer than 2,000 years? Isn't the Chinese writing system much, much older? And this is the kind of philosophical definition. What is a writing system? You could say it's not one writing system, it's five different writing systems. It's the Chinese writing systems, and the oldest one is the Oracle Bone script. And of course, this is not some kind of continuum, and it's about to say where you put the breaking points in it.
And now some remarks about the type design. We chose a monolinear drawing. The goal is to be as close as possible to the ductus. No serifs, a medium white, and a low contrast. We are aware that with this design we could lose some information, but the intention here is to focus on the basic forms and see all the scripts of the world with the same way. Deborah Anderson is working in collaboration with experts from all over the world. They provide accurate historical and linguistic descriptions about the script. The quality of documentation varies a lot. Further research is often necessary to understand the ductus and the drawing. So we have different levels of complexity for drawing the glyphs. Here you can see the more simple ones. Sources were pretty good. To inscribe the glyph in an imaginary square, sometimes we had to modify glyph's proportions. This is the second level of complexity. Here are some examples of bad sources where the part of interpretation is huge. This is the third level of complexity. And to finish, most complex signs are obviously pictograms, but we had to harmonize them with all of the glyphs to be able to compare them.
After finishing a first version of these glyphs, we sent them to type design experts. Some of them are here in the audience, region by region. So this is the opportunity to say thank you to these people. They helped us a lot because, of course, we are not the experts for all these different writing systems and regions. And this is one of the examples from the return from the experts. As you can see, it was very helpful.
For example, with the COM script, according to Ben Mitchell, our first source and drawing at the top was incorrect. So he helped us for the choice of the reference glyph to the final drawing. This is one of our work documents with some questioning about the drawing.
And at this point, we're working to harmonize them, of course, to see how they matching together, and even we changed some of these reference glyphs.
Here you can see a part of a proposal for the script Elimaic. We have access to very rich documents to learn easily the principal qualities of each script. There is no standard form of Elimaic. For purposes of the encoding, the representative Elimaic script is based upon that of the stone inscriptions. While there are differences in the shapes of some letters across the inscriptions, they may be considered stylistic or local variations.
And the letter A is in the first row of this chart.
On the wall, the scripts and the inscriptions exhibit uniformity and convey the sense of a single writing system. So you can see the evolution of the drawing with the formal choice we made at first and information we had.
Paleo-Hispanic was a special case. There was a university in Barcelona who asked Script Encoding Initiative to help them on a proposal, on the Unicode proposal, and then they asked RNRT if we could draw a whole set. So this was the work for Arthur Franchietta, a student at ANRT. The Paleo-Hispanic script is from around about 700 years before Common Era on the Iberian Peninsula, so today it's Spain and Portugal.
This is important for the paleograph team to make transcriptions, for instance. Arthur Franchietta from ANRT did this type design.
So for this one case, we did the whole alphabet.
The first observation Arthur made at the end of this project was that during the standardization and integration to the Unicode, the type design would require a lot more attention. Encoding proposals should benefit from type design expertise much more thoroughly. And that would allow for a proposal with more appropriate structures of the different writing systems. The encoding of a writing system aims to making it accessible within different tools, but it's also a way to save scripts and spread them.
So here they are, 146 glyphs for 146 missing scripts. These are, so Arthur Franchietta and Morgan were the two students at ANRT who had this time of 18 months to do the research and the type design. It was supervised by the whole staff from ANRT, but in a special way by Jérôme Knebusch and myself. And if you are, I'm sure here are some experts from some for some writing systems in the audience, if you look at one of these glyphs and you think, oh, it should be in a different way, this stroke should be like this and this stroke should be like that, of course, so please contact us. Of course, we know this is some kind of beta version. We think of it like the first version, and then we can say we can do another version of the poster or on the website we are working on. So it could be interesting to see just a run through all these scripts via region. So you see the output of these regions. These are as far as we know. All writing systems from America, Europe, Africa, Middle East, Central Asia. The most writing systems coming from South Asia, of course, this is India, Pakistan, or the Indus Valley script, the first from the Indus Valley. East Asia, Southeast Asia, and Oceania. And there's one from Australia, which is the Bliss symbols, the third from the left, from Mr. Bliss from 1949. So the first media where we would show these research and the glyphs, of course, is a poster we did in silkscreen. There's a color code, so it's printed in four colors, and the color code explains if this writing system is encoded in Unicode or not, or if it's historical or living. So you see the bluish, two bluish colors on the left is like already encoded, and the red and orange, slightly different colors, means these scripts are yet to be encoded. So here you have a look at this, a part of the poster. Below each reference glyph, there is the name in English, of course, then there is the region and the time frame. And of course, the time frame is sometimes fuzzy. We try to have the best information from these various linguists. And on the border of the poster, you see on the left, there's a kind of timeline that you can see proto-cuneiform. Cuneiform is really the first one, 200, 300 years later, their neighbors, the Egyptians, took the idea further, as far as we know today. And if you look at the bottom part of this poster, the lower part, you see when you can distinguish the orange color, that there are many, many writing systems invented in the 20th century, even in the 21st century. The last is from 2006 or 7. And the orange color will indicate that these are living scripts. There are some communities of just 100,000 people somewhere in Africa, and these scripts are not yet encoded. And here is the whole view of the poster, and we have some special guest here. It's Thomas Huot Marchand, director from ANRT, who will show you the poster in real.
Thank you very much.